Hey, creative friends. Well, check it out. I am finally trying out Lightburn. I know it's taken me forever. I've had my diode laser now for several months, and I'm just now getting a chance to take the time to set up Lightburn. You know, many reasons. Of course, I do this just for fun on the side, so, you know, time's definitely a factor, but we also only, for our family, only had one laptop that we're constantly using between the four of us, and so that was part of the issue. So I've just gotten a few weeks ago, a Microsoft Surface tablet, and everything is loaded just fine on it. So I'm running Inkscape and Cricut Design Space and now Lightburn on this tablet. And so I've taken an Inkscape little doodle and brought it into Lightburn and played around with some offsets. And I've got two layers. And so one is doing the engraving. So I wanted it to use a fill. My second layer is hopefully going to cut. And again, this is my very first time trying this out, so I don't know what powers and speeds to use. So that was just a guess. And it's coming along nicely, and so it is working on my little heart shape at the moment, doing an engrave, and then hopefully it's going to do a cut. Sorry about all this focus. I hope that's gonna work okay. But let me get some light on so you can see what the project is. There we go, get some natural light. And so it is currently engraving. This is just kind of like a little signature doodle for me. I doodle this little heart shape all the time. And so it's doing an engraving of the doodle, and then hopefully it's going to come back and do two passes to cut through this piece of cardboard. And so we shall see. But thanks so much for all the information and the help. This is a wonderful community. I just really appreciate all of you for watching and for helping me out and learning about these gadgets. And now I see what you guys mean about Lightburn. I've been watching all kinds of the tutorial videos, and it really is a neat program. So I don't know, someday I still want to invest in a CO2 laser, so that may kind of dictate which route I go based on the software that will run those CO2 lasers. So definitely something to consider. All right, so I'm going to just let this keep going, and then I'll come back as it's cutting. Okay, just coming back to capture some video. I think it is just about finished with the engraving, and then we will see what's happening. This is kind of exciting, getting to try something new for the first time, but we will see what happens. Wow, look at that. That is so fast. And so it just went through twice. And look at that. I may talk to you just a little bit later in another video about getting my Lightburn set up, but thank goodness I think this older version of my NAJ 30 Watt Plus 2, not the 2S, but I think it does support the homing because it did go back there. All right, so let's see what happened. I don't know if that, you know what? I don't know if that was enough to cut through. Oh, and I hate to move it. All right, so now I'm going to go figure out if I can figure out how to do just one layer and keep trying to cut that. Okay, so again, I'm just experimenting. I turned the show to off, and so that hid the engraving part, so I'm assuming now it's just going to do the second layer for me again. And so I changed the speed back down to 30, still left it at 80% power. So let me see what that's going to do. Oh, it looks like it's trying to engrave again. All right, let me go in and stop that. Okay, now let's see if that's going to cut through, and then I'll show you. I did have to come back, not only turn off the show, but also turn off the output, and then that way it just did that second layer, which is doing the outside cut of my heart. And if I come back and look at this cardboard, Still doesn't look like it cut all the way through, so I'm gonna bump up the power and try that again. Okay, so I've dropped this down to just 10 for the speed and then 100 for the power, and again, it's gonna go twice. So hopefully that's gonna get this piece of cardboard to cut. And I probably have moved this ever so slightly as I've been testing it, so who knows. Okay, let's see. Oh, I don't know. I'm just gonna lift it up and go for it. Yeah, nothing. It did not cut. So obviously, I still have some work to do to figure out these settings, but all in all, I'm so excited because, of course, Lightburn, as all of you know, the Neijay software, it's a two-step process to engrave and then come back and cut. Two separate files, but with Lightburn we can do both, and that engraving just looks great. It almost looks like just a marker. So anyway, I'm gonna have fun with this, but thank you guys for watching, and hope you have a great weekend.